I needed to say good morning personally to my counterpart of the Ethiopian Tax Reset Network, because I was meeting him for the first time, and we're very happy to see the Ethiopian delegation here present. Can we give the Ethiopians a round of applause, please? So, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, executive chairman, and others here present, I'd like to welcome you all to the third annual meeting of the Nigerian Tax Research Network. As a brief introduction, the Nigerian Tax Research Network is coordinated by the International Center for Tax and Development and funded by the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. The network was launched in 2017 here in Abuja, and at the same event, the ICTD, that's International Center for Tax and Development, and the FRS signed a memorandum of understanding for cooperation on research and capacity building. As the chair of this network in Nigeria, I'm very pleased to see this partnership flourishing 2 years on with the hosting today of the first session of what will be a year-long course on policy-oriented tax research here at the FRS Training School this week. That training was concluded yesterday and will continue for the rest of the year. I'm also delighted that there are participants on the course from the Ethiopian Tax Research Network, some of whom are also joining us for this conference. I'd like to extend a special welcome, which I've done, to our Ethiopian guests, as Nigeria and Ethiopia are two of the continent's biggest economies that are also federal states. I believe there's much to be learned in sharing experiences and lessons between these two sister research networks. And let me just go back a little bit into history. When we're putting in place the idea of having an integrated tax administration system in the FRS, and we looked at all different possibilities of economies who we could learn from, we chose the Ethiopian Tax Authority for the team at the time to go and to understudy what Ethiopia was doing. Because we found out that there were a lot of lessons to be learned, not just in terms of putting in place an administration system, but making it work for those who didn't really know how to use the computer, making it work at the smallest community level possible. So once again, we'd like to thank Ethiopia for sharing with us those experiences and continuing to regard Nigeria as one with whom we need to partner in making Africa a much bigger continent, a much greater continent than it is today. This is the ultimate goal of the two networks, Ethiopian Tax Reset Network and the Nigerian Tax Reset Network, to enhance the generation and exchange of tax knowledge. These networks are not only about funding research projects and publishing papers, they're about bringing research and policy making together in order to not only raise more revenue, but to contribute to sustainable development. As we proceed with a lot of the changes in Nigeria with the bank verification network of the tax identification we had some time back and building on it, and actually the growing level of the national ID system, you're going to find that data is becoming increasingly important. And data and research, I would say, are Siamese twins. The more data you have, the more you need to invest in research, you need to invest in analytics to see how we can use this data to contribute to development. And so the launching of the network in 2017 couldn't have been more timely. And as we continue to pursue this objective and the vision and the mission of why we set it up in the first place, we've come to a point where it is becoming really invaluable in development, in policy matters, and at a time when we're talking about renewable energy, there's more investments out there, and there's a lot of talk about the dwindling oil revenue, this couldn't have come at a better time. So what we're doing today should be seen, therefore, to go beyond just listening to research, or listening to what people have done, or exchanging ideas, or leaving it at just the four walls of what we have today. It should go to actually how do we use what we are discussing today to truly, at the end of the day, drive revenue development. And let me also say that in talking about exchange of tax knowledge, it's not just about revenue generation. It's about ensuring that it actually ultimately drives to ensuring we truly develop our continent based on the research papers and based on the revenues that we are generating. So it's very important that we bear all that in mind. We've organized this conference with a series of panels that will showcase the latest high-quality research on a range of issues that are directly connected to pressing tax policy and administration challenges we face in Nigeria today. If you look at the agenda, and I'd just like to refer you to it, you'll find that we have different panels all set out to do justice to the various topics that are laid out. Let me talk about the theme so that we can relate the panels that we've set up to the theme. The theme of the conference is revenue challenges online and offline, bridging the digital divide in an analog economy. And let me touch on two very important issues in this regard. First is the first part of it, and there's ongoing work being led by the OECD on the tax challenges of the digitalization of the economy. President Muhammadu Buhari recently, in EXCO, with EXCO's approval, changed the name of our Ministry of Communication to the Ministry of Communication and Digital Economy. What does that tell you? It tells you that Nigeria truly recognizes the power of digitization. The executive chairman of the FIRS has also, in repeated conferences and in repeated interviews, has talked about how we really need to tax the digital economy. And so again, what are we doing today? We're bringing to bear what is topical, what is relevant, what is driven at the highest possible level, and we're asking ourselves, how can we therefore take that, we've set the direction, what can we take from it, and how can we really push that agenda forward? Nigeria is a member of the inclusive framework and is thus participating in the global debate about how to tax digitalized multinational businesses, which has precipitated contentious negotiations about how to reform the international tax system in order to make it both more fair and fit for the 21st century economy. But let me also add that beyond taxing digitalized multinational businesses, we also have a growing level of local businesses that actually attribute their growth and success to being completely digital. We have people who have run their business completely on Instagram from beginning to end, and they're growing and they're recruiting and they're creating jobs, and the question is, how are we taxing this group? So we recognize the job creation, we recognize that they're growing, and we recognize that it's important, but to what extent, therefore, are we as a government taking the most revenue from it to be able to develop and actually invest, because telecommunications is not cheap infrastructure. To be able to power the telecom infrastructure, to be able to ensure that everybody around, the over 200 million people we're talking about, and even close to 400 million in the next couple of years that we're having, to ensure that every single person is connected, that's a lot of investment. So how do we therefore take advantage of what's the drive or what's going on? The second issue it touches on is the potential for digital technologies to improve the effectiveness of tax administration and facilitate tax compliance. Both these issues were the theme of the International Conference on Tax in Africa, which took place 2 weeks ago and was attended by over 400 participants from 37 African countries. As Chairman Mr. Fowler has said, and we know, also being the chair of the ATAF Council, the theme of the conference was digitalization and harnessing technology to improve tax systems. There's clearly much to be gained by leveraging technology in tax administration, such as enabling online registration, filing and payment of taxes, and for automating processes with systems like ITAS. However, this brings me to the second part of our theme, bridging the digital divide in an analog economy. In Nigeria, much of our economy is not digital, with key sectors including oil and agriculture. Further, about a fifth of adults in Nigeria are not literate. Only about 40% of Nigerians are internet users, and less than a third are smartphone users. Further, there are uneven capacities across the country for implementing complex IT systems. So although there's a great deal of optimism about the potential of digital technologies for taxation and debates about how to tax giant digital companies like Google, Amazon, and Facebook, there are also real cost-benefit tensions and different kinds of constraints to examine here in the Nigerian context. So we hope, because I'm speaking here not just on behalf of myself, but also on behalf of all the hardworking members of the Nigerian Tax Research Network who've pulled together to make this conference possible. We hope that over the course of this conference, we can discuss both the challenges that we need to address, as well as the opportunities that should be seized when it comes to digital technologies and taxation. And let me say that the discussion should not end here. Let's use it to drive change. Change in policy, change in legislation, change in the way we do business on a day-to-day basis. For us, that's really our success. That's the barometer of whether or not this conference has been successful. But before I end, and I know we've done a lot of handshakes and claps and applauses to really congratulate the FRS, but I really want to say a big thank you to the FRS for hosting this event. This would not have been possible in this grand way, and like, who was it? The five-star training center, without the Federal Inland Revenue Service hosting this. Can we give them another round of applause? We're also very grateful to the Research and Development Department for their help with the organization, to the immigration liaisons for helping to arrange visas, to the training school for hosting us here, and to the security and the housekeeping staff who have made us and everyone who's been around here feel welcome and safe. Thank you all, and I'm very much looking forward to spend the next 2 days here with all to engage with the research and discuss these important issues. Now, I forgot one thing before I end. There's a young lady, 7 years old, sitting in the audience who's always been wondering, where is mommy working so hard? Why does she travel so hard? And so what I did today was invite her to be part of the participants so that she knows what mommy does on a day-to-day basis. And I'd like to say thank you, Nete, for allowing mommy to travel. So please give her a round of applause. Thank you all, and we look forward to a very interactive 2 days. Thank you.